land. Look at the great societies they built. People want to be told how to act. And most people are idiots, and that's exactly who my teachings appeal to. This lawless, permissive society has no boundaries, and without boundaries, how do you know where the limits are? You have to know what's good and what's evil. You need someone to tell you so. Single moms have obese kids, it's a fact. While rich people have a lot of guilt, unnecessarily, in my opinion.
I agree. I don't think these people understand just how hard it is to potty train. You have to give a treat when Precious makes it poopy. My kids are big-boned, and they eat prunes every day. But that's what's wrong with this country. All of this emphasis on being thin and healthy. When my children are hungry, I hand them a spear and send them out to the park to catch their own food. They're learning how to be self-sufficient. Yesterday, my youngest, Jono, killed the postman. But at least he was trying. So I gave him a cuddle. I told him to hit Daddy next time he comes home late, smelling of cheap perfume.
Okay,
it's time to take a break before we hear about any more criminal acts against government employees. You're listening to Pressing Issues. Morality is the subject at hand. Let's explain exactly how free radio without commercial breaks works. We'll be right back.
You're listening to VCPR. Finally, a radio station for teachers and librarians. You've been enjoying Pressing Issues, but as is normal, you can't listen to an hour's worth of programming on this station without us begging for money. It's the Bi-Daily Begathon here on VCPR, where we hold your favorite shows hostage until you pony up some cash.
You know what's so great about VCPR? It's like a shining torch of cultural enlightenment for Vice City. In these times of darkness, when the hordes are so uneducated they can barely understand multisyllabic phrases like, clean my shoes better, Marissa, or I'll report you to the IRS, or dialectical materialism. Isn't it pleasant to have a patronizing voice on the radio?
That's right, Michelle. With the way things are going under Reagan, at any moment the unwashed Huns from the Midwest could descend upon Vice City and enslave the poets and postal workers and force us to watch network programming.
That is a frightening thought. But like many things in life, you can throw money at something and feel better about yourself. VCPR is your public radio station, but you have to open your wallets.
That's right. If you pledge at the $1,000...
You are as good as dead!
Liberals will be set on fire in the streets. Give now. Let's return to Pressing Issues. Over to you, Maurice, in the studio. Useless, talentless.
Throw that piece of shit out
the I love those guys. Really professional and living proof that all of the best talent isn't on commercial networks. These people do it for love because they have integrity, just like me. We're back with Pressing Issues. I'm Maurice Chavez, winner of 5 public radio awards in the Vice City area, including... down to simple ones so you can understand. On this segment of the show, we are discussing morality. Since the beginning of time, man has asked questions. Why are we here? What time is it? And is there a place around here a guy can get a drink? Early man, as seen in the cave of Lascaux in France, questioned the morality of making the mammoth... Recently, Vice City considered passing a public curfew that says nobody can be on the streets after 8:30 p.m. Of course, the bill didn't get passed, but it made people think. If you don't vote, you get morons in charge. Is that moral? I'm not sure. Let's press the issue.
Children should be at home with their parents naked. A curfew makes sense. You know how much money I save not having to wear trendy clothes?
Goodness, get back behind the divider. Please, I'm married.
What's so wrong with me? Why do you hate me because I'm happy? Jack, give me a hug. I won't hurt you. And by the sound of things, your husband is doing the same right now with his secretary.
No, we worked through it. He was stressed. It's hard keeping a family together these days.
Everyone, take your clothes off and feel what it's like to be free. Feel the wind from the air conditioning. Oh, the breeze is so liberating.
Thanks very much.
Now, if you could get back behind that divider, Barry, please. Otherwise, I'm going to have to ask you to leave. Now sit down. On pressing issues, we think it is very important to respect one another. To treat each other like we would like to be treated.
I want a hug.
If you don't like the United States, son, why don't you move to Russia? I don't understand people in America today. They call this a cold war, but it's hotter than hell. Mark my words, end of day now, you're sitting in...
Sponsor who supports the art of public radio, buddy.
I, for one, welcome our new Russian masters. We can learn so much.
Out of my way.
Kids are screaming for ice cream and pop. I may just douse myself in kerosene. I use that as a threat to my kids all the time, so it's no wonder they're so screwed up. That's one of the tough things about being a mom, not ruining their lives with guilt. As a matter of fact, I don't let my kids watch cartoons or slasher flicks.
Really?
That Knife After Dark movie may be number one in the box office, but my kids certainly ain't gonna see it. If you don't raise your kids right, they end up being like Mood Boy over there or working in radio. I want them to get proper jobs, like being a doctor, not a patient.
That is offensive. My mother understood I was special. She made me wear a bonnet as a child, and when I demanded to go to school naked, she was fine with it. After social services moved me, she would still write to me. I still remember when she kissed me goodbye.
But Barry, earlier you said you discovered naturism, taking your clothes off, whatever it is in Germany.
I know, but I lie a lot. I've got a lot of personal issues. Look at me. Please, Maurice, I need a hug.
There's another example of immorality in this city. Public showing of affection. People think we want to see the making out and carrying on. I understand your hormones rage like a wild animal, and you want to ravage one another like there's no tomorrow, but you have to ignore what your body is telling you and work for a higher calling, like construction. We're building a statue, and we need your help. Call me now.
You know, pretty soon you won't be able to tell who's a human and who's an android. Why, the corporation is working on it right.
If this is what you want.
I'm sorry, Maurice, but I have to tell you, I moved to Florida to bring my kids up the American way in a theme park. And that's just the kind of person I am, opinionated and moronic.
I see. Well, this panel is certainly interesting. The issue is morality. Recently, rock artists joined together to provide famine aid to Alaska with the song, Do They Know It's the 4th of July? Critics complain it's immoral to meddle in the affairs. Business like an over-opinionated sociopath.
Well, let me say that money could have gone to much better things, like reserving a place by my side in the Pastor Richard's Salvation statue. But I digress in blood.
Stop doing
Don't
that.
Interrupt me, boy. Anywho, I address the Alaska issue in chapter 23 of my book. You see, the Alaskans are lunatics, plain and simple. They eat whales and snow and asleep in the freezer. Who wants to eat snow every day? Oh, I tried to help. I sent a helicopter with copies of my book, but they burned them in a pile for heat. If the people of Alaska choose to live there, let them. But don't come crying when you're tired of eating penguin and it snows 18 feet a day.
Yes, but don't you think it's important?
I think it's very important to listen to me, young man. That's what makes the state of Florida great. Rather where they are, people nationwide abandon their hometowns, come down here and shove their beliefs down everyone else's throats. That's the American way, always has been. We should send some pictures of Florida to those people in Alaska. I tell you, they throw down that bear pelt, saddle up the sled dogs, and get pulled all the way to Vice City. And I should know, I'm from Mars.
No, you're not. Mars, Alabama. I am the courage is there.
The problem with Alaska is that people don't get naked. If you can't work on your car, or play the cello, or use sharp knives in your birthday suit, then what's the point of living?
Well, it is a bit cold there. People put on clothes when it's cold. We evolved without a warm covering of hands.
That's a lie, sir. We come from the great meteor of fruit.
Clothes are a habit, like shaving and taking out the trash. As soon as you stop, you realize what a prisoner you were to society and the twisted state of morality. People think that nudists are immoral. Well, we're not. I'm married, I love my wife. In our commune, it's so wonderful to wake up in a big bed and go to breakfast, clothed in nothing but a smile.
What kind of people are there in your weirdo commune?
Single people, families, elderly couples, teachers, politicians, and especially truck drivers. Truck drivers understand what it's like to be by yourself for days on end, with nothing but country music on the radio and a stick in your hand, shifting gears over and over. Truckers realize there's nothing to be ashamed of on the open road. Get naked and beat it on down the line. You've never seen a sense of community and morality like a nudist colony. We share everything, the cooking, cleaning, wives, a shared sense of what it's like to be a complete social outcast.
Wait right there, Barry. I'm getting something through the cans. Headphones, that is. Yes? Yeah, okay. We just want to tell you a little more about public radio funding. We'll be right back after this.
Hello, I'm sure you're enjoying our high-quality programming. I'm Michelle Montanius. Jonathan, I think it's time to acknowledge the people who are sending money in to shut us up and end this dreadful begathon.
Here's a $10 pledge from Fran and Little.
No man, he's not a problem.
They want us to wish you well. Dig deep and dig soon.
That's right. At any moment, conservatives could vote to end our funding and place a fast food restaurant where our studios are.
You make me run and I'll get all sweaty.
Come to a T, man. 31.
Freeze on, much like the moon, on Times Square.
Welcome back. The show is pressing issues. The subject is morality. I'm Maurice Chavez. Let's carry on pressing the issue. Now, when the Europeans were done ruining their continent with bland food and soccer riots and arrived in the Americas in the late 15th century, the subject soon turned to morality. You see, Europeans wanted to colonize America, so they had somebody to make fun of. The pilgrims left England for the religious freedom in Holland, where they visited coffee shops, and after they packed up their ships with plenty of coffee, tea, and cakes to liven up the trip, they set sail for the New World, which they heard had a magnificent waterfront. Once they got here, they were very hungry, having been on a ship for 65 days. So they ate for 3 days straight. Thanksgiving quickly became an annual custom. America was founded by people who wanted a place where they could tell other people how to live. And I'm a history major. But do we have the right? The question, is it moral to celebrate Thanksgiving, a holiday that is clearly about gluttony, annoying relatives, and awful
gossip? What are you doing? Well,
baby.
And abused. It happened to me, and look at me. I'm a deranged mess, and my husband cheats on me. I don't want my kids to go to a pub.
For a transmission, I need to be distracted by your privates dangling about. Now, when I go to the store to buy an air conditioning filter, I'd rather not have to look at your moneymaker, amigo. I'm glad you are proud of it. But when people of Vice City are in a quickie mart, they should be able to have a simple financial transaction without seeing your fire hose. Are you with me?
Sorry, Maurice.
It's okay. Just try to behave. I think the sun must have got to you or something.
Yes, maybe that's it.
Maurice, if I may, you have a fine show here, and I'm glad to be on it. But everyone within the sound of my voice and smell will die in the fires of doom. It is written. TV is trash. Radio is trash. Our newspapers are run by Canadians with an agenda. Our very way of life is threatened. We form this great...
My car,
I'm after it. I've got a clear shot.
Central, Mobile International.
It's okay to be scared. Get off of me! I'm happily divorced!
Shall I send him to hell, Maurice?
Yes!
Hands on your head, pal!
Together. I'm Maurice Chavez. Bye. Please don't kill me.
I hope you will enjoy addressing issues. I certainly was.
Yes, it's almost as interesting as listening to you, Jonathan.
Thanks, Michelle. It is, isn't it? Before we let you get back to the show, I thought you'd like to know VCPR has managed to raise $30 this hour, which should keep us on the air for another 15 minutes at least.
It's great.
Okay, I'm going to have to interrupt you. And on the left, I have Positive Thinker Extraordinaire, a man who dragged himself up from the gutter, Jeremy Robart.
Hey, the ghetto, not the gutter. I didn't live in the gutter. I live in the ghetto. I'm a survivor, not vermin. I'm from the streets.
Okay.
Hey, I can teach you how to be a survivor, too. All of you. I can help everyone. I've got what they...
Thank you.
intervention. It's easy. All you have to do is follow my simple program on audio cassette or VHS.
Okay, not right now. This isn't a commercial. And if you're not going to underwrite the station, I can let you read these patent books. People pay for that.
Hey, everything in life is an opportunity. When I was in jail, I got the idea for my current business. And look at me now. I got offices in Vice City, Bogota, Lebanese, and Jamaica. If I can do it, I can help you make something of yourself. You could be just like me, a success.
Hey, enough, no more. Not a word from you until you are called upon again.
It's a three-stage process. Learn, start, do it.
Shut up. I'm warning you, this is my show. You shut your mouth. Shut it now and keep it shut. Do not push me, you shiny-suited prick. Do not push me.
Hey, you have to dress to impress. I cover that in my program. People make judgments on who you are based on your appearance. Scientists say we form 98% of our opinions on a person in the first half second we meet them. Hey, and if scientists say it, it must be true. I teach you how to live that.
Enough! This is pressing issues. Enough now, okay? Enough. Please, no more. Okay, my last panelist is someone without a plan to serve. Without a program, but with a beautiful message. So it says here, Vice City Civilian of the Year for 1985, Jenny Louise Graff.
Hi, Maurice. This is such a lovely studio.
Thanks. How are you doing?
Great. In fact, I'm fantastic. Did you see the sunrise this morning? It was gorgeous. I've been smiling all day ever since.
Okay. Now let's get with the policy of ladies first. And since you seem to be the most pleasant person here, Jenny, let's start with you. You seem like a very happy person.
Oh, I am.
Really? Why?
Well, life's great, isn't it? I mean, good things come my way because I hold each one close because I deserve it.
I bet you wouldn't be so cheery if it was the Black Plague. Jenny's living in a fictional world. Gods like me, we see the world for what it is. Dark songs of the night, black nail polish. Very tight gap jeans, man.
Like, everything is great. Everything!
Konstantinos, you're shaking your head.
I know, Maurice. I am.
Any particular reason?
Yeah.
What then?
There's only one thing good about life.
And what's that?
Death.
Death?
Yeah.